One, two, three. They're still married. They're still married. They're still married.
Hello, my name is Zachariah with Old Man Gaming. Sitting next to me on the couch, sitting loosely, she's basically laying down. Yes. We can only hope she doesn't fall asleep through this, is my lovely, talented, beautiful Bostonian wife, Melissa.
I'm trying to figure out why the hell people were traveling the Oregon Trail.
It was land, it was gold, it was a whole mess of things. So, shall we continue with the Oregon Trail?
Yeah.
Unlocked. Guidebook unlocked. This is Aftermath from the prologue, guys.
Yeah. The Nature Trail. Play at your own pace, a wagon full of supplies. More wildlife to discover, or the classic Oregon Trail experience. Pack your own wagon, face additional hardship. Here, do the one that sounds fun and relaxing, or kill yourself.
We're definitely going to do the kill yourself.
Yeah, thing. Why not?
Like, after you've said that. I think we get, like, procedurally generated characters, too, which is really cool.
We don't get to design and, like,
I don't know,
make our own character. So I love that. This is 1849.
She'd love it until she died of dysentery.
Right. Your first journey begins in Independence. This is John Half Moon. I don't want to be like,
just,
I can't do
it. Just read the normal.
Reach a fort to unlock it as fast travel as a unlock it as a fast travel location. Once unlocked, you can hire a guide to take you straight there on your next attempt to reach Oregon.
Okay.
I'd like to point out that made it look like Oregon and Independence were like somewhat parallel to each other. Not parallel, but like,
ooh,
like level with each other. Oregon is like super northwest of Independence, Missouri.
Right.
Take a journey across 2,000 miles of plains, rivers, and mountains. If for some reason you don't survive, your wagon burns, or thieves steal your oxen, or you run out of provisions, or you die of cholera, don't give up. Try again and again. And again, maybe you don't die of dysentery in this, you just get cholera, which we know causes dysentery, but they, like, don't want to say that you're shitting yourself.
I 100% know the dysentery is in this game.
Oh, is it?
First of all, I'm pretty sure I saw it in the trailer, but if they took dysentery out of Oregon Trail, which it is the most known, like, there are shirts that have Oregon Trail, you died of dysentery. Like, if they took that out of this game, that's insane.
I wanted to say, we've seen cholera. They specifically say die of cholera. Cholera, I believe, is it causes you to shit yourself and puke, which would cause dysentery.
We watched Harris do that. Yeah. We had a bad time.
He looks fine now. Who should be your first party member? The banker, athletic, and brilliant. I don't believe for a second that in 1849 there was a female banker. But whatever. The missionary.
I believe it.
Slack optimistic. What is slack?
I don't know what slack means.
Or the farmer, hedonistic and neat.
Which one?
I say Lulu. I want the female banker. She's brilliant. She's athletic. She's got money.
Lulu's in.
All right. The farmer is brilliant and kind.
Levi.
Molly. It would be Levi.
It would be Levi.
I think so. Missionary, hedonistic, and
pugnacious.
What does that mean?
I think it's like stubborn. Like, not just stubborn, but like, he doesn't go down
easy. I want brilliant, kind people. Levi.
You know, like frail, egotistical Molly?
I mean,
she's... Ooh, that's the wrong button. Levi.
Adventure.
Her name is America.
Grace, adventure, religious, hedonistic. America, missionary, frail and wily. And Ruby, missionary, neat and egotistical.
What are you thinking?
I mean, do we want a hedonistic person?
I kind of like Wily, to be honest.
But she's frail.
Yeah, yeah.
What is the times one? What does the book mean?
I don't know yet. We haven't figured it out. I'm going to assume that that gives some sort of bonus to something that has to do with faith.
No, the ones with the cross does.
Right.
That makes sense for faith, but the other one.
Well, that was the icon for the guidebook that we unlocked.
Let's go exactly with her. Sure. She's an adventurer. Grace. Religious. I don't like the idea that she's hedonistic.
Oh, a lot of religion in the last one.
Messy and paranoid, kind and brilliant, egotistical and pessimistic. Yeah, that sounds fun. No.
So Ira, the kind Ira, and brilliant, yeah. brilliant missionary. Do it. Oh, we can change their names.
I don't know. I'm all right with names.
Okay. All right. We can change their names, though.
Okay.
For sure. Let's go in on them for a second. Oh, no. It just allows me to change them. Okay. Lulu, Levi, Grace, and Ira. Let's do it.
Not sure what to buy? This kit is perfect for greenhorns just setting out on their journey. Or, if you prefer, you can start from scratch and choose your own supplies. Here's some snake oil for you.
Well, we only have $650.
Okay. Contains Murphy wagon, flour, bullets, clothes, medicine, toolboxes, wheel grease, bait, clothes, coffee, medicine, toolboxes, meat. We have nothing to start out, right?
Nothing.
Okay.
Well, we can say start from scratch, and then we can go through and purchase everything ourselves. I think that's a bad idea.
I think that's a bad idea, too.
Until we really...
So this one, that one was meat. This one has meat and... Stop changing it. Go back.
Oh, okay.
That one has bullets and meat.
Yeah, this is the hunter's kit.
And medicine. The other one had meat, no bullets. The first one had bullets, no meat.
Right. But you also have to look at what it has other than that. Like, that one has medicine and toolboxes. This one is... Oh, it has medicine and toolboxes.
Yeah.
Same amount of coffee, medicine, toolboxes.
Clothes.
That one has clothes.
Medicine, toolboxes, wheel grease, flour, bullets, no meat.
What do you think?
Go to the next one, I think.
Hunters.
Meat, medicine, toolboxes, clothes. I think that's the one to do. I know it's the most expensive. I say select.
Oh, it gives us... So that plus one, it gives us one of those items.
Okay.
Is a hymn book that we got. Because then we got the guidebook, and we also got the harmonica and the money from the girl, remember?
Okay.
So that's what that does. It, like, gives us a thing. Pay now. Pay and leave store. Confirm. Alright.
Talk, trade, store, services, rest. How are our people's stats right now? Can we see that? Like, is everybody healthy and... Everybody's
full, okay. We're starting from scratch.
And we might as well depart, right?
Yeah. Yeah, I don't see a reason why not. Why not? Just to depart.
All right. These women don't really look like they are dressed to
Okay, so I can just access the map whenever I want.
Okay.
I think, because that's what I just did there.
Popular river crossing, the first challenge for any westward bound party. Pelts can be useful for sealing the wagon before crossing. Avoid a broken arm. All characters must survive. Oh, I see.
It's a reward, the challenges.
I gotcha.
Oof. Okay, how are we gonna get there? And we've never been there before, so we don't know what it is.
Right.
Nice. So So I think meager and strenuous is good since they're fully healthy. And
agreed.
Then let's pick the...
I say the lower one.
Lower one? All right.
Ow. Void of broken... As morning breaks in independence, our intrepid travelers take their first steps on the Oregon Trail. The adventure begins May 1, 1849. Spirits are high. Everyone is in peak physical condition. The wagon is stocked and the party is filled with vim and vigor.
10 days later, everyone's right. Dead!
Kansas River Crossing, 70 miles. Everybody still seems in good shape.
Doing good, doing good.
What are those, the green dots?
That's everything filled up in our wagon.
Okay.
So like, without knowing what it is, it's just the space.
A bison lies in the dirt beside the trail, unmoving. It doesn't appear to have any external wounds or evidence of sickness, at least at quick glance. However, further investigation may be necessary to determine the safety of any meat.
What do you think?
We have 200 pounds of meat and we're burning 12 pounds a day. Mm-hmm. I think we leave a dying animal. We don't try and, like...
Push on?
Yeah.
All right.
We don't want tainted meat. The party decides to leave the carcass to the crows.
Jeez. Wouldn't it be great if we went to the bison? They all died of dysentery, like two. Like 5 miles in.
We're not that low on food at all. Whoa! The party is at a complete loss for words. It's not every day that a man falls from the sky. Regardless, the responsible thing to do might be to offer some assistance, assuming he survived the fall.
What do we do?
I mean, I think we should help him.
Should help him? Hey, this is the West, baby.
At least see. I mean, he stands up. Samuel Peppard.
Oh, can I do him?
Twisting in the wind, sure.
Consort, looks like I've run out of steam again. I knew these engines were nothing but trouble.
The strange man dusts himself off.
Isn't that violent? That fiddle.
Excuse me, where are my manners? My name is Samuel Peppard, and I thank you kindly for your help just now. What you just witnessed was my latest invention, a flying machine. Though I admit, it was something of a work in progress. I'm having so much fun with this voice. All that's missing is the right source of power. Steam engines, modern though they may be, are simply not up to the task.
Samuel Peppard strokes his chin in thought.
So we should marvel at his idea or dismiss his idea?
What's his idea? That steam engines aren't good for flying? I mean, is that something to marvel?
I mean, I don't know. That's up to you.
Or just the fact that he has a flying machine. That's something to marvel.
Your call, leader.
All right, marvel for a minute. We'll entertain him.
You are quite right to be impressed. I have studied the work of Sir George Cayley, an English inventor who has already built a working heavier-than-air glider. It's only a matter of time before humanity achieves the dream of powered flight. My dream is that an American will be the first to make such a flight. Indeed, if the winds are favorable, I see no reason why it shouldn't be me.
Samuel Peppard looks as excited.
It was a pleasure to meet you. Perhaps we will see each other again. After all, who knows what the future holds? I shall endeavor to spy you from above.
That's creepy, Sammy.
Yeah. So where the fuck does he go?
Samuel Peppard's Folly. What is a new quest? Is that... Hold on, I'm going to check it out. The quests.
We met an eccentric inventor who fell out of the sky. We look forward to meeting him again.
Oh, it's just meeting him again, I guess.
Okay.
Interesting. So it's just like it keeps track of your plot threads. Okay.
Carry on. Carry on.
Carry on.
Carry on.
Hunting is ideally suited to those who have spent time in the wilderness, requiring keen shooting skill and the ability to track prey through challenging environments. Those with low stamina will be unable to carry back much meat. Who should hunt? The party has 100 bullets.
I kind of feel like we should just not hunt. We still have 188 pounds of food.
I'm kind of in agreement.
All right, let's push on then.
The party pushes on past the herd, continuing down the trail.
Then we found out that's deer for the next time.
Yeah.
So should we go? What's interesting too is you find out that it's deer here. So I guess every time we discover a deer, we discover all the deers? Maybe?
All the deers?
Yeah,
because... With an S?
What? Like the deer icons.
Mm-hmm.
Oh my god.
Deer...
I know it's plural.
Is deer.
I was meaning like the deers as in the like...
Yeah, yeah.
The icons. I wasn't referring to the animal. I'm saying that like each one of the icons, maybe we discover all of them,
mm-hmm.
find one of the animals.
Okay. You know, it'd be
frustrating lady. Which mm-hmm. which one should we go to? Should we go to the deer or should we go to this one, the undiscovered one?
I say go to the undiscovered one. We're all still in good shape. We really, do we have any like pelts or anything though? Because we will need to hunt before we get to the river. The party notices a sickly looking woman standing near a broken down wagon. I almost did not see you, thank goodness I did. There is no sign of the woman's companions, if she has any. The party is unsure what to make of her. Should someone offer her assistance? That's tough.
Yeah.
I feel like it could be an ambush. There's bison in the back, too.
Yeah, we could also talk to Grace, I guess. Maybe that'll give us more information.
She is Grace, isn't she?
What?
She is Grace.
Yeah, but this is our Grace. This is talking to her Grace.
All right, let's talk to her. Please, if you could spare me some clean clothes, I'd be truly greatly obliged. Given the state of her wagon, a change of clothes hardly seems adequate to ease Grace's condition.
So should we go back and then have somebody assist her? Instead of just giving her the clothes?
Go back.
Yeah, back. It'll take us back one screen to the people.
What do you mean?
Like to the screen before where we could select someone to assist her or talk to her.
Oh, I see.
Like that's what that back will do.
Well, yeah, but I thought that meant select someone from our group to assist her.
Yeah. So do we want to go back and have somebody assist her instead of just giving her a set of clothes?
I mean, isn't giving her a set of clothes... Yeah, let's just see.
Because it says that it's not going to really help her.
Okay.
And I don't want to lose the clothes...
I see what you're saying. There's no sign of the woman's companions. Does she have any... Da, 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 da.
So who should we have help her? We don't know who's good at this.
Ira? Yeah. Are you in trouble, ma'am? We would be happy to offer any assistance we can. That is most kind of you. I'm trying to make my way back east. My poor husband, he... Her voice trails off.
He day.
Will not survive... Oh.
Grace will not survive on her own.
But if she is traveling in the opposite direction, there is not much that can be done for her. Ira resolves to share some comforting words with her before they part. I bet he does.
Ira, compose your minus one.
While Ira kind speaks, Grace's demeanor visibly brightens. Seeing the hope in her eye gladdens the hearts of the party. Do we get some morale for that?
I think Grace does. I think that's what was important. Mm-hmm. Ira,
I
mean,
all
lost.
Of our guys are up pretty good.
Yeah, but he lost some something in his other substance.
Yeah.
So
like, let me see. That doesn't say he lost anything. I want to know what all the attitude, composure, wit, that sort of stuff.
Well, was. Like the loyalty, he just got loyalty, didn't he? I think he just obtained the loyalty for doing that.
Oh, so we could see that he had 6 loyalty. Okay, I see. So we discover it by using him.
Yeah.
Okay.
Like they all start with health, morale, stamina, hygiene.
So that was more like to figure out what who has what.
Yeah, and here I'm like,
okay.
They're hiding in the bushes to ambush if we save her. Fish team in the water nearby, a prime location to cast a line and try and catch a bite. Though bait is required, the party could craft some. The party has zero baits.
What do we craft bait out?
Worms. With a little time, the party can craft some bait from suitable food the party has in storage. Fish bait can be created from spare fish and foodstuffs. The party has 0 fish and 0 pounds of foodstuffs.
So we are not fishing today.
Yeah. So push on.
We haven't tried fishing. That's why I wanted to try and do it.
Party leaves the fish to their peace. Continue. Feel like we should have gone the other way so that we could hunt. Because we don't have pelts to cross the river.
Well, we don't know that
we
that
need
was
to kill
the spot.
A bison.
That might have been a...
While gathering water for the camp, Grace finds some turtle eggs buried on the bank of a nearby waterway. The eggs might be gathered and cooked for food, though some in the party might find such an act unsavory. What should be done?
What are we doing with the eggs?
Turtle? Can you eat turtles?
Yeah.
Turtle eggs?
Yeah, you can eat turtle eggs.
Sure, gather the eggs.
Tonight we dine on turtle soup?
Yeah.
I'm married to Shredder. Jesus. Okay. I hate real life turtles, so I'm okay with it.
I don't know that I would want to eat one, though.
Well, I don't think...
Where are we eating turtles when we have...
Ooh. Party morale.
Oh, we got foodstuffs.
We got foodstuffs after we move.
Grace decides to gather the eggs, regrettable for the mother turtle, perhaps, but a necessary sacrifice.
It got us back up over 200 feet. Winter in 196 days.
Is it going to take us that long?
I don't know. You know what, though? Can we pause it? Because we got to end this episode, lady. We're at 22 minutes. Hi, ladies and gentlemen. We're still on the Oregon Trail. This is a lot of fun. I'm enjoying this.
Mm-hmm.
Aren't you?
Yeah.
We're going to see if any of us catch dysentery next week. You guys can reach us on Facebook at OldManGamingDH.
Or
on Twitter.
Cholera.
Or cholera. At... Where was I? You can reach us in... My train.
I'm sorry.
You reach us on Facebook at OldManGamingDH or Twitter at OldManGaming9. You can join our Discord. Links in the description below. You can influence this in all of our shows from there. We will be back next week with at least one more episode of Oregon Trail. And as long as you guys keep watching and listening, we'll keep making them.
Bye.
Bye.